So who am I? I'm David Warner, and that's all my stuff there. So feel free to reach out. We'd love to collaborate with each and every one of you. Let me know if you have any questions. So yes, as Hugo mentioned, we are going to talk about the community today and how you can contribute. We have all kinds of samples and solutions and guidance that you can find at our community site. Community.ms or ak.ms/community/home will take you there. You can see things like Copilot prompts and library components, all kinds of list formatting, all kinds of stuff, right? Now, there's also some Copilot Pro Dev samples that are available, but you'll notice that if you come here and go to each and every single one of these, they're going to take you to the individual repo. And that might be a little hard to go and find everything where you want it to be. But did you know that we have a sample solution gallery that rolls all that up? So how do you get there? Well, you go to adoption.microsoft.com, right? So you go right over there, and it will take you to the adoption page for Microsoft. When you come under solutions, you're going to find a sample solution gallery link. And that is going to take you to what is an aggregate of all of the samples that are available within the community from all the different repos in one easy-to-use space. So when you come there, it'll take you to a site that looks like this. And so you're going to see some featured samples. You're going to see a collection of products on the side, ways that you can filter, you can sort, you can search, and so you can find what you're looking for. So today we're talking about Copilot Pro Dev samples, and I know Paul is going to demo that here in just a little bit, but let's set that up for him. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to do a search on agent. Okay, well, great. Now that is going to potentially come across a number of different products and technologies. It might be that there are different agents in different technologies, but I'm looking for a Microsoft 365 Copilot prompt. So what I can do is, you see, I've currently got 69 total results. And so if I come over here and filter, now I've got 54. So now I know that I'm seeing a little bit more of a focused result set that I'm looking for. So I'm going to scroll down here. I'm going to look for something that looks, Oh, look at that. I'm looking for something positive. We want to contribute in a positive way, right? So there's Paul's positivity agent. So how would I use that? How would I get to it? I'd come over to positivity agent. It would teach me and show me a little bit about what is going on here, right? It's going to tell me references. I can download it directly from GitHub if I want. I can view it on GitHub, which we'll do in just a moment. Bonus, when you contribute a sample, you are going to get a dedicated profile page here at adoption.microsoft.com. So here you can see that we have a collection of Bullock samples, right, from Paul Bullock. And this is a great way to show your involvement in the community. It's a great way to show all the ways that you contribute. Obviously, our badges are a great way too, but this is kind of a nice showcase of all of your samples that's put together by Microsoft. So it's a really, really cool way to kind of say, hey, if you'd like to see what I've been doing, check out my badges, but also, hey, check out all the samples that I've created. It's great for speaking. It's great for all kinds of stuff, right? So it's our way of kind of saying thank you to all those that are contributing. So I'm going to go back to here, and we're going to come back to GitHub. And that's what we want to do, because we want to look at how we can not only take advantage of these samples, but also, hey, maybe we want to contribute back. Maybe we want to edit or improve an existing one or enhance it or a brand new one. So we're going to get into what is going to become a little bit of a sharing is caring session here. So I'm going to click on view on GitHub. And it's going to take me into the individual sample, and which is great because sometimes, let's face it, GitHub can be, a little hard to navigate, and it's not the best UI UX, right? It's true. So we want to make sure that we understand it, but don't get overwhelmed by it. So it's going to take you directly into the sample that you can see here. So we can scroll down. And we can see an overview of the positivity agent template. We learn a little bit about it. We're also able to see all the different things that are associated to it, the assets and the code and the environment, all the stuff that's associated. And this is across all the products and samples, by the way, everybody. So really GitHub is kind of the same way for all of them, but we're just focusing on the Copilot Pro Dev samples today. So what if I had my own sample? I love the positivity vibe that Paul is doing. What if I wanted to contribute back? Well, let's jump into that little mini sharing is caring. So I'm going to go back up to the root. Now, this is going to take me to the root of this repository, which is PNP. I want to click on that one right there. My bad. That was going to take me up to the very, very account. So I want to go to the root of this repository, which is that link right there. And then what you're going to do is you're going to do what's called forking. Now, if you're unfamiliar with forking, it just means you're making a copy of the repository in your own account. And why is that necessary? It's so that you can upload files, because in the production version of this repo, none of us have rights unless we're an administrator. So we need to be able to put our files somewhere to get put into production during what's going to be called a pull request. So I'm going to click on fork. And it's going to take me into creating a new fork. And you want to leave this repository name here. It says you can change it. And if you've already forked it, then you're going to need a different experience. But we're going to make the assumption that it's brand new for everybody. We want to leave that the same. And you're also going to see this copy the main branch. And that's fine. You could leave that the same too. Now, what I will say is, let me back up just one. I did want to mention that each repository has a slightly different potential requirement for contributing. And you can always find that at the contributing file. Now, for us in the community, that's always going to be there. You're always going to be able to click on the contribution guidance or contributing markdown file and find what the suggestions, the naming structures, and the convention sample folder, what's required for the README, what assets you may need, right, to be able to make all that work for you. And so you can follow that. And that's going to be specific to the individual repo. Okay, so once you've reviewed that, you can come in back into fork, and I'm just going to say create fork. And again, don't get caught up in these confusing verbs and languages and names. We'll explain them. And if you need a refresher, again, go join the Sharing is Caring once we get that scheduled. Okay, so now I forked it, and what it's allowed me to do is essentially, you'll notice, I'm now in my own account, and I've got a copy of that repo, and I can see that there. I can see here it's told me it's forked from Copilot Pro Dev Samples. I can also see it up here in the actual URL, so we know that I'm no longer in production. So there's no fear that you're going to break something. You're in your own safe space. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to say, well, okay, I've got my own little agent, Captain Compliment, right? I want to contribute this agent from Captain Compliment into the contribution samples for this. So how could I do that? Well, typically what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to go in and potentially install some software for Git or GitHub, or you might have to use VS Code, which is okay, right? If you have it downloaded and potentially an extension or something like that. But did you know that you could just do it all through the web? There is absolutely a feature here that is going to turn VS Code on in the web. But how do you do that? Well, there's a couple of different ways, one of which is using a magic key combination on your keyboard, and that is just hitting the period key. But what that does is it's just GitHub listening behind the scenes for that keystroke to have been hit. What actually happens is, and you can do this anytime on any GitHub site, just come change that .com to .dev. That's all that's really happening. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to come up and I'm going to go .dev and I'm going to hit enter. And now you see it says setting up your web editor. And what's going to happen is it's going to take me into my web editor for VS Code. And so now I'm literally in VS Code working with GitHub in the web. I had installed nothing. This is amazing, right? It's super, super amazing. In fact, we need a woo. That's right. So now how can I do and work within the web? Do I still have to upload each individual file one by one? Well, no. Watch this. So if I come over to Captain Compliment and I go to look at the properties here, then I'm going to see that this is 14 files and 4 folders. Okay, awesome. So now we kind of know exactly what we're working with. I can literally copy and drag and drop this. And so I'm going to do that. I'm just going to move it over here and I'm going to drag and drop. And you'll notice that the samples kind of lights up when I do that, right? Kind of gets a little bit of gray. And don't worry, yours is not going to be purple and orange. That's just me and my Warner Digital favorite colors. But I'm going to copy this. I'm going to drop it. And now what happened is you'll notice that Captain Compliment showed up here with a little A, which means it's adding. And so now it's there. And you'll see that when I look over here at my source code, that's what that little button is representing of. Is my source code says 14. Well, where do we see 14? When we looked at the property. So we know that it added 14 files, and we can see that. I come over to source control. I see 14 files. I could even look at it if I want to in a list view here. It's just showing it in a tree view. If I wanted to just see them by themselves, I could do that. But tree view is a little bit nicer. Okay, now I am moving a little fast. Remember, you can join a sharing is caring session. But if I come up here, now it's just being stored directly in my browser. It's just temporary file storage. But I need to do what's called committing, which is a fancy way of saying save. So I'm just going to say adding new sample. And I'm going to hit commit and push, right? And what that means is it's pushing the files up into GitHub. All right, so I'm going to hit that. We're going to see that number disappear and be available to us now. And so that's indicative of the fact that we are done. We contributed, or I should say we added it to our GitHub. So now I'm going to go back to my repository. I'm going to get the little hamburger menu. I do wonder what a pizza menu would look like. Anyways, go to repository, and it's going to take me back to my repository. So now I'm in the Copilot Pro Dev samples, and it tells me your branch is one commit ahead. That means that I've added something. It's ahead of production. And so now I'm going to come to the contribute button, and I'm going to go to open pull request. Now, for a lot of us, pull request is a very weird term, and we go into detail on this on the sharing is caring session, but let me just give you the nutshell version. Remember, in Windows or Mac, when we're using Explorer Finder, we're used to pushing things around, right? We move folders from one location to another because we're typically administrators on our machine. But remember, in this scenario where we're working with a production repository that we do not have administrative rights to, we can't push anything up the chain. So what we do is we store it in a copied version in our own account, and then we send a request to the repo maintainers and the repo administrators of production and ask them to pull it in. So essentially, it's kind of a reverse of what our minds typically think, at least it was for me. So a pull request is, hey, I am sending you, Mr. or Mrs. Maintainer, a request to pull these files from my machine up into production, a la pull request. All right, so I'm going to open that up. And I'm going to show, it says adding new sample. And so let's just see, you typically want to fill this in and make sure that you get some description in here. A lot of them already have templates, right? But I've got one here that's ready. Every repo needs a hero, not the one we deserve, but the one who aggressively believes in our potential, right? I looked at this code and whispered, wow, clearly this wasn't vibe coded because, hey, it actually works. I know, it's a little joke, but okay, so that's how you'd fill it in. You would add a little bit more detail on the title, and then you would click create pull request, leave the allow edits by maintainers on, because that allows the maintainers to work with you and make changes if need be. This was a very rapid approach to understanding the ecosystem of the samples. Hopefully you found value in it. Again, go join a sharing is caring session. We go into more detail. We walk you through it. Like I said, this was a nutshell version of it, but that's kind of your process to doing it. I think I went a little over 7 minutes. So I apologize. On this 7th of August, I was trying at 7 a.m. Pacific time, trying to get in 7 minutes. It didn't quite work. No jackpot for us. But this is how you would start creating a sample and contributing to the community. So go get involved. Go to community.ms. Let me hand it back to Hugo. We're going to get into a little bit more detail on some of those Copilot Pro Dev samples. Hugo, back to you.